Hello, my name is Gloria Casas, and today I'm going to present one of the experiments that we have conducted to evaluate the nutritional value of rice co-products. The title of this presentation is The Effects of Full-Fat or Defatted Rice Bran and Microbial Xylanase on Growth Performance of Weanling Pigs. Let's start describing what is rice bran. Rice bran is a rice co-product that is produced in the rice milling process, when the brown layer from the brown rice is removed. This fraction contains the alluronal layer, the pericarp, the embryo, and some fraction of the endosperm. When the oil is not removed, the product is called full-fat rice bran, but sometimes the oil is removed and results in a product called defatted rice bran. The nutritional composition of the rice bran makes this ingredient an important source of energy and crude protein for pigs. This graph shows the concentration of crude protein and fat in these ingredients. The red bar represents full-fat rice bran, and the blue bar represents defatted rice bran. We can see that the concentration of crude protein is about 15% in these co-products, but the concentration of fat is 16% in full-fat rice bran and just 2 or 3% in defatted rice bran. This graph shows the concentration of NDF in these co-products, which is between 20 and 25%. The relative high concentration of NDF in these ingredients is one of the factors that prevent greater concentration of full-fat rice bran or defatted rice bran in diets for weanling pigs. However, previous research have demonstrated that adding enzymes can improve the nutritional value, especially the concentration of metabolizable energy. Henderson in 2012 demonstrated that the full-fat rice bran contains some bioactive components that can improve the immune response, specifically the concentration of immunoglobulin A in mice. And also, Herfel in 2013 demonstrated that the full-fat rice bran may have prebiotic effect. However, it's unknown if these effects can be reflected in the growth performance of the pigs. For that reason, we conducted one experiment to determine the effects of full-fat rice bran and defatted rice bran on growth performance and blood characteristics of weanling pigs. In this experiment, we used 532 pigs that had 9.3 kilograms of body weight on average. These pigs were allowed in 14 treatments in a randomized complete block design with 4 blocks, 2 replicates per block, and 4 or 5 pigs per pen. Here we have the experimental diets. All diets contain corn and soybean meal. The rice co-products were added at the expense of corn at 10, 20, and 30% of inclusion level. All diets contain also 10% of whey powder and 3% of choice white grease. Calcium phosphate was added to the basal diet, but no additional source of phosphorus was added to the diets containing full-fat rice bran or defatted rice bran. 7 additional diets also were formulated. These diets also contained 16,000 units of microbial xylanase. All diets contain 1,500 units of phytase. Blood samples were collected from 1 pig per pen that was on the average weight of the pen. This sample was to measure BUN, total protein, and albumin. Also, we use ELISA kits to measure the concentration of TNF-alpha as an indicator of inflammatory response and prebiotic effect. We also measure immunoglobulin A as an indicator of immune response and the concentration of peptide YY as an indicator of homeostasis of feed intake and energy. Now let's move on to the results of this experiment. Here I will show the results of the main effects of the enzyme, ingredient, and inclusion levels because the interaction between these factors were not significant. This slide showed the effects of the xylanase on growth performance. The orange bar represents the performance of pigs fed diets without xylanase, and the blue bar represents the pig fed diets with xylanase. We can see that there was no effect of xylanase on growth performance parameters. That may be explained by the low inclusion level of full-fat rice bran and defatted rice bran that imply low concentration of substrate for the enzyme. There were no effect of xylanase on the blood characteristic or in TNF-alpha immunoglobulin A or PYY concentration. Now let's move on the effect of ingredient and inclusion level. In this graph and in the following slides, the orange bar represents the parameters for pig-fed diets containing full-fat rice bran, and the blue bar represents the parameters for pig-fed diets with defatted rice bran. We can see that was a significant linear effect to decrease the feed intake as the inclusion level of the full-fat rice bran increased, and also was a tendency to decrease the feed intake as the content of the fatted rice bran increase on the diet. Also, the average daily feed intake was greater in pigs fed diets containing full fat rice bran than in pigs fed diets with the fatted rice bran. For the average daily gain, was a quadratic effect of inclusion level of the ingredient. The average daily gain increased at 20%, but then decreased at 30%. Also, it's important to mention that the average daily gain at 30% was not different to the average daily gain for the basal diet. Similar results were observed by Warren and Farrell in 1990 and by Herfel in 2013. For gain-to-feed ratio, there was also a quadratic effect of full-fat rice bran. There was no effect for increased inclusion level of the fatted rice bran, but the gain-to-feed ratio was greater for pig-fed diets with full-fat rice bran than for pig-fed diets with defatted rice bran. The concentration of BUN decreased as the inclusion level of full-fat rice bran or defatted rice bran increased on the diets, and the concentration of BUN was greater in pig-fed diets with defatted rice bran than in pig-fed diets containing full-fat rice bran. It can be explained by the reduction of the feed intake that we mentioned before. Also, we observed a linear tendency to decrease the concentration of TNF-alpha in pigs-fed diets containing full-fat rice bran, but no effects were observed in pigs-fed diets with defatted rice bran. PYY is a peptide synthesized in the distal portion of the small intestine in response to neuronal or nutritional stimuli and function to regulate the feed intake and homeostasis of energy. In this experiment, the concentration of peptide YY were in the range observed before for pig-fed ad libitum. Also, we observed a tendency to decrease the concentration as the inclusion level of the full-fat rice bran increased in the diet. There were no effect of inclusion level of the fatted rice bran. From this experiment, we conclude that there was no effect of the addition of xylanase to the diets containing full-fat rice bran or defatted rice bran on the variables that we tested. Also, we conclude that it's possible to include full-fat rice bran or defatted rice bran at 20% of inclusion level on diets for weanling pigs without affect the growth performance. Full-fat rice bran may reduce the inflammatory response, but further research is needed to test that hypothesis. With this, I finish my presentation. Thank you for your attention, and if you need more information about this topic, you can visit our website.